on Nutanix automatically with Rancher. So I will start sharing my screen. We will start. I have created a dedicated virtual machine for this demo, so I will connect on it. This is a basic Ubuntu machine. I just deploy it. And when we want to create a Rancher management instance, what we need is a first Kubernetes cluster, because Rancher will run inside a Kubernetes cluster. So the best practices given by Rancher is to use their small K3S product to deploy a Kubernetes cluster quickly. So I will launch this single command, and you will see in less than 1 minute, we will have a Kubernetes cluster, a first one running inside this VM. So it will be pretty fast, and we will use this Kubernetes to launch the Rancher instances inside. I have chosen Ubuntu for this demo, but globally K3S is supported on many different Linux distributions. So if you look, that's already done. I can just ask to see the nodes of my cluster, and I will see I have a working cluster now on this VM, start from 20 seconds. So it was a new created cluster. Let me just split my window in two parts. We connect back on the same VM. Yes. Okay. And I just want to display a quick dynamic view on the cluster, but I just forget to copy my configuration file, who by default is in Rancher inside the main kube config folder. So now I have a UI instance on my cluster, and I have my freshly deployed cluster. So the next step, that's pretty simple. There is mainly two steps to make on the cluster. The first one is to install the only dependency you have to install Rancher. There is another component who was not made by Rancher called Cert Manager. Cert Manager is an operator who allows to manage easily all the certificates inside a Kubernetes cluster. And there is two steps to install it. The first one is to install the custom resource definition of Cert Manager, what I do here. And after that, we will use Helm to just deploy the Cert Manager inside the cluster. So I launch Helm, and you will see in the top window, I miss someone. What I miss, I just forgot to. Is Helm installed? Yes, I just forgot to add my correct repo, my Helm repo, to be able to install all the components. Just let's add it and just update the Helm repo. Okay, so I will just launch my Helm install Cert Manager again, and you will see they will create automatically a new namespace. You will see it here. And you have the Cert Manager component who starts coming inside this namespace. That's the only prerequisite you need on top of a Kubernetes cluster to be able to install your Rancher management server. The last step is, once the Cert Manager is deployed, to install Rancher himself. So that's just another Helm chart. So we just need to create a dedicated namespace for that. The default one is called kettle system. And after that, I will launch an Helm command. There is two important properties you need to define inside the Helm install command for the Rancher. The first one is the host name of the management host where you are installing the Rancher instance. In this case, the idea is to give an information who directly link to my virtual machine. In this case, I have already give a DNS name inside my virtual machine, so I will just give my name. But if you want, you can, for example, use some external services to translate DNS name in IP, like sleep.io or zip.io, and use this kind of stuff if you don't have access to DNS. After that, we just ask to have a replica of one, and we will give the first password to connect to the instance, to the Rancher instance, and that's all. So you will see there is a new pod within progress here, container creating, and this is the Rancher pod. So we will let a few seconds, and in the meantime, we can just use the output of the previous Helm command to automatically generate the URL where you need to connect to be able to use this Rancher instance. So let me just copy the URL and add a browser to my sharing screen. So you can go inside the Rancher install documentation. If you want to do the same stuff, you go to the last Rancher 2.6 documentation, and there is a quick start guide, and you will follow the Helm CLI quick start. This is the easy one. If you just have a VM, it works perfectly. So next step will be to connect to my new Rancher instance. So the URL, I get it from the Helm install. I will put it inside my browser, and I will just wait that my pod is passing in running state with a ready to one, just to be sure that all is already ready. And it's coming. I can try to start first, show details, visit this website, accept the certificate. That's not yet ready. Let's wait a little bit again.
So Christo, in the interim, could you summarize the first steps that you have to take?
Exactly. So globally, just create a virtual machine. Inside this virtual machine, you install a Kubernetes cluster. For example, in this case, by using a small product from Rancher called K3S, that's like a simple Kubernetes distribution, but you can also use other kind of distribution if you prefer. But if you follow the quick start from the documentation, they give you the path to use K3S, and it works pretty well. Once you have your Kubernetes cluster, you are connected on it, you need to install two stuff. First one is a dependency cert manager. If you don't know Cert Manager, you can look on the Cert Manager website. This is an operator who allow you to easily manage all the certificate lifecycle inside a Kubernetes cluster by using some custom resources. So that's a very powerful product. And this product is used by Rancher to manage all the certificate inside Rancher himself. So the last step is to deploy Rancher also with Helm, as we do with Cert Manager. So last command is an Helm install on the Rancher component. And few minutes after, you will have a working Rancher instance. So if I just refresh.
In that sense, Christoph, because many times we talk about Rancher and Rancher, there are different kind of products within Rancher, right? So we are talking about the Rancher control plane, where now you will deploy a cluster on IHP, right?
Exactly. The main Rancher product is what you call the Rancher control plane. Usually we call it just Rancher, but this is the main product who allow to manage multiple Kubernetes cluster, to deploy apps, to manage lifecycle, and we will see some additional demo of this product in a few minutes.
And if a customer already has Rancher, they will have potentially already
this
website, they just deploy directly.
Exactly. What I want to show you here is the entire process to be able to install by yourself the demo. But if you start talking with a customer who already installed Rancher, maybe outside of a Nutanix cluster, you will just jump to this part, and let me just click on continue here. You will arrive on the Rancher UI directly. So that's something will look like you see on the left part. Let me just increase the size of the window a little bit. But globally, that's the main Rancher interface. So sometimes the customer is able to clean it a little bit like that, but that's a pretty simple interface. And starting the last Rancher version, so 2.6.4, you have a native integration of Nutanix. So if you click on the menu here, you go inside cluster management, and you need to check inside drivers, and inside drivers go to node driver, because we are the goal is to manage the Nutanix platform to be able to create Kubernetes nodes, and Kubernetes nodes inside the Nutanix platform is virtual machine. And you will see by default here, if you are in the last version, you have the Nutanix driver with already installed in an inactive state by default, but it's already installed. So what you can do is just click on the driver and activate it. You can also decide if you don't want to put a lot of mess in your UI to disable the one you don't plan to use. just to remove a lot of mess on the UI when you will make additional choice later. Let's just keep some of them, but remove the majority. So after that, once I have activated my Nutanix driver, now you see it's active. The first thing I need to do is create what we call a template, a node template, and specifically for my Nutanix driver. So I go inside RKI1 configuration, and I will go to node template, and I will be able to add a template. And in this case, they show me all the driver I let enable, and I will choose the one for which I want to create a node template. So in this case, I will select Nutanix, and I need to fill this form and give the information I need to connect to the Nutanix platform and to create my virtual machine. So globally, first point is a Prism Central instances. So I can use IP or name here, a username and a password. And in this case, the password and the username need to be an admin account who have the permission to create virtual machine. After that, I will target a specific Nutanix cluster. If I have multiple clusters inside my Prism Central, I will choose one of them. And next, I will give information on my VM. This is a template. I will create a first template, but I have the ability to have multiple templates inside my Rancher platform. So for example, I can create a first one. My two templates can connect to the same Prism instance, to the same cluster, or maybe to different clusters. And I can have also some different resource size. If I want to define multiple VM t-shirt size, I can create multiple templates to be able to target this different size. So the first one, I will keep the default value, for example. I will give the name of the template image from the image library inside Prism Central I want to use. So in my case, I already have a cloud image template from Ubuntu, and I will use it. I can decide to resize this template. For example, usually the cloud template you get from internet are pretty small, between 2 and 5 gigabytes, but that's too small when you need to use it to install a Kubernetes cluster. And after that, the container engine need to download a lot of image. You risk to attain the limit of the size of your disk. So you can decide once you deploy it to increase, for example, the size of this disk. I can also add additional disk if I want and define in which container I will put my additional disk. By default, the template image will stay inside the container where they are existing. Another information I can give is cloud config information. This cloud config information allows you to personalize the VM once you deploy it. By default, the Rancher node driver already use cloud config to create a root user and to define dynamically a specific key to connect to the VM to be able to make the Rancher configuration. But if you want to add, for example, additional user, or if you want to make some additional command inside your VM to be able to personalize what you need to install inside the VM, you can put it inside the node template. Let me give you an example. I will use this one, for example, where I add additional user named Chris with a specific key. And I will also launch some command to update the package library. And after that, enable iskcuzi package and add an additional package for NFS. These two packages, for example, is mandatory if I want to use Next, the CSI to connect to the Nutanix platform. So you can put it directly inside the cloud unit to have a ready-to-use VM once they deploy it. Last information will be to define a network, of course, to connect your virtual machine. You can define if you want multiple networks, and you can also assign some categories. And last part is to give a name to my template. Sorry, I will call it CloudPod Small, for example, because I have only two CPU, and I will save it. And I can duplicate it, for example, clone it, and I will just change the size of the VM, and I will call it CloudPod Big. Let's do. So now I have two templates, two node templates. So let's try to use it. I need to go back to clusters and I will create my first cluster automatically with Rancher. So I click on create. I will select Nutanix to provision my cluster and I will give a name to my cluster. So I will call it cluster one, for example, and I will create multiple node pool. By default, you have one node pool. I can call it cluster one control plane, for example. I can add a second node pool, cluster one worker, for example. And you decide which template you want to use. For example, I can decide to use the small or the big. I just created before. In this case, I just want to use the small on my boss pool. But I can decide to have different pool attached to different templates to target, for example, different Nutanix cluster or different instance size or maybe different template image or different cloud image settings, different network, everything you can modify inside the template itself. I will just change the role I give to each of my pools. The first one will be control plane and etcd. The second one will be only worker. I can change also the size of each pool. I have some additional options, but with more specific to Rancher, like the Kubernetes version, the kind of CNI I want to use. There is plenty of deep options you can set, but for the moment, I will let it like that. Once I have clicked on create, what the node driver will do is to start communicating with the Nutanix cluster and start creating some virtual machines. So if I go to the Prism Central cluster and the Prism Central view, I will see I already have some tasks, create VM. I have three create VM, CP1, worker one, and worker two. So if you remember, that's exactly what I have asked inside my cluster one. I have two pool, the CP pool for the control plane and the worker pool for the node, with one node inside control plane and two nodes inside the worker. So if I go back to the Nutanix view, I already have these three machines created. So let's switch to the virtual machine, make a filter on cluster one, and I will see now my three VM already created globally with the right information I have given. Two vCPU, 4 GB of memory. If I look inside the NIC, normally I am on the DevOps network. So globally, you have all the stuff you have asked inside the node template. So now the last thing you have to do is just wait. Maybe this is the more longer part. It will take 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes, depending a little bit on the speed of your machine and the speed of your internet connection to deploy the cluster. And after that, you will start to use the cluster as any Kubernetes cluster inside the Rancher interface. You will see the cluster appear inside this part, and you can start using the cluster through the UI, through the Rancher UI, using the marketplace to add some additional components. You can deploy all the add-ons you have in Rancher. So you have the full power of Rancher, but the goal here is to be able to use this Rancher node driver for Nutanix to be able to automatically manage all the VM creation inside the Nutanix cluster and to have a true native and transparent experience inside the Rancher UI directly. I see there is a lot of questions in progress. Do you have some open questions? No, it seems that you already replied to all the questions, so that's perfect.
So Christoph, meantime, networking, because I guess that some people are wondering if we can use new flow networking VPCs.
Sorry, can you repeat the question?
Rather than using VLANs, can we use flow networking VPCs?
The flow, the VPC from Nutanix flow, okay. Globally, you have no limitation on this part because you have the ability to select any kind of network inside the template when you are inside the let me show you inside the cluster management inside the node template. You have the ability to give any kind inside the template any kind of network here. The only thing you need to take care, because I never try it by myself, depending on the kind of VPC you create, as a management plane need to be able to connect directly to the node, you need to have a full routing between your VPC and the external network. If you have what I will call an hide VPC, where an outgoing NAT, when you want to go outside of the VPC, you will be not able to deploy your Nutanix, your Rancher Kubernetes cluster on Nutanix in this case.
So the, let's say Rancher requires connectivity to the virtual machines that deploy and not the agent to Rancher, right?
Yes, sometimes yes. That's why there is a SSH connection.
Okay, thank you.
Let's check the status of the cluster. In the meantime, if you have other questions, don't hesitate.
Yes, so we have one there that we will hold it once you have finished. That is about using Rancher control plane on NKE. But I guess that there are some also different angles there. If it's about running this Rancher that we have on the screen on NKE, or actually using this Rancher to manage an NKE
okay
cluster, but we can cover that once.
We can cover the both part of the question, because the both are interesting. If we talk about the management plane itself, so what you see on this screen inside the internet browser, in this demo we have used K3S to install the first Kubernetes cluster, and we deploy the Rancher management in it. We can also, if you prefer, use an NKE cluster, use a Carbon engine to deploy the first Kubernetes cluster, and after that, install the management cluster inside the NKE cluster. You have some limitation in this case, because if you want to add additional component, you can have some collision with some default add-on coming from Carbon. For example, the monitoring stack we are deploying inside the Nutanix Carbon cluster can cause trouble and forbid you to install the default Rancher monitoring stack. So that's why you can also, we are talking about the management cluster, you can do also the same inside cluster when you want to add a cluster, we make a create cluster previously, but you can also decide to import existing Kubernetes cluster. And in this case, that's not to install the management cluster on a Nutanix Carbon cluster, but that's to be able to manage a Carbon cluster from the Rancher UI, whatever the place you have installed the Rancher management cluster. And in this case, you can say import a generic Kubernetes cluster. And in this case, you just give a name to your cluster. For example, I will call it Carbon One. And next, what they will do is to give you a command to apply on your Carbon cluster to be able to register your Carbon cluster inside the Rancher management plane. So you launch this command against your Carbon cluster. They will automatically deploy some components, the Rancher agent, and after that, they will connect directly to the management plane. And what you will see inside the cluster view here, as you have the Carbon one, we are not yet available because I don't launch this command inside the Carbon cluster. On the command is launched and on the Carbon cluster is connected, this interface will become blue, like my local one with my K3S1. And what is the state of my, the cluster one is not yet fully deployed, so it takes more time as expected. But globally, yes, you can also manage some additional cluster directly from Rancher, even some external cluster like Carbon cluster. But like I said before, if you don't use the default deployment method from Rancher with based on the on their own Kubernetes engine called RKI, you see it here, the cluster one, the one I deploy automatically with the Rancher node driver, the Nutanix Rancher node driver is deployed with their own Kubernetes engine RKI. And in this case, this is you have the full power of the Rancher UI. So inside this cluster, I can click on it I just need to refresh my window home, so I can click on cluster one here. I have a full view, and I can go, for example, in cluster tools and add some additional component. For example, the monitoring component. I have also a service mesh component. I can use a policy component. All these components will install perfectly if you are using RKI, but in case of Carbon, for example, if you import some Carbon cluster, when you will launch the monitoring install, they will cause trouble because they will start to reinstall something we have already inside Carbon cluster. So that's called the Prometheus operator, and they will try to deploy another Prometheus instances, and it will be remove some specific Carbon component, and they will break your Carbon cluster. So we can do it. We can import Carbon cluster, but we just need to take care to not deploy some specific component like this one. So last thing you can do just to finish, sorry, José, on yep. the cluster you have just installed, you can go inside Apps and Marketplace, and you can search for Nutanix, and you will see you will have access also to the CSI component. So you can quickly deploy the CSI snapshot and the CSI storage component. And in this place, you will also have some wizard where you can give a lot of information if you want to deploy, for example, the volume and file settings for Nutanix. You will define the Prism endpoint, the username, the password, some settings, and so on. So exactly what you do when you install manually a CSI inside a Kubernetes cluster, but you have it directly inside the Rancher Marketplace.